Water Corporation is the main supplier of water, wastewater, and drainage services in Western Australia. It helps to ensure we have enough drinking water for the future by developing new sources, increasing water recycling, and encouraging efficient water use.
We know that the water we use in our schools, homes, and businesses is clean and safe for us to drink, but do you ever think about where that water comes from and the journey it takes to arrive at your home?
In Perth, we have four main sources of drinking water: surface water, groundwater, seawater, and groundwater replenishment. Surface water is the rainfall that flows into our dams. This has given us a reliable water source in the past, but our drying climate means there is less rainfall and, as a result, less water in our dams. We also have a vast groundwater system that provides about 40% of our drinking water, and this is also a never-ending source, and it also relies on rainfall to top it up. Seawater is a resource that doesn't rely on the climate, and now seawater desalination plants make up a sizable contribution to our drinking water supply. Groundwater replenishment is the newest water source, which involves treating wastewater to drinking water standards and recharging it into existing groundwater supplies. The water is then stored and removed sometime later for further treatment, ready to supply our drinking water system.
Like all water that makes its way into our drinking water supply, groundwater goes through a thorough treatment process to make it safe for us to drink. Today we're going to find out about how that's done here at the Wanneroo Groundwater Treatment Plant.
Hi Oscar, how are you going?
Hi Siobhan, I'm good, thanks. So Siobhan, how is water treated to make it drinkable?
There are different processes for treating water depending on where it comes from and the quality of the water to begin with. So here we take water from groundwater bores and put it through five basic processes: aeration, MyX, clarification, filtration and disinfection.
Generally, most of the plants across Western Australia use standard treatment. However, at this plant, we treat the water using MyX, a special, innovative pre-treatment process which stands for Magnetic Ion Exchange. It helps treat the variable water quality of Perth's groundwaters. I'll explain this more in detail later.
So, where is the water at this plant coming from?
The water comes from bores at two main locations north of Perth, Wanneroo and Pinjar. Now, bores are essentially vertical pipes that go down into the aquifers. Now, the aquifers are areas underground where water is stored in between rock formations.
Are these the same garden bores we have at home?
They're similar, but they operate on a much larger scale. So your average garden bore can source water underground at around 50 to 100 metres. The bores at Wanneroo can go down around 800 metres. And the water is relatively warm down there. It's about 37 degrees. Here, you can feel how warm it is.
Whoa.
Yeah, that's 37 degrees.
Okay, so you've taken the water out of the ground. What's the first step in the process?
The water that comes in from the bores has high levels of organic materials like iron and hydrogen sulfide, and that's what gives the water its brown colour. And when the water first comes into the plant, the first process is called aeration. And as you can see, air is being blown into the water, which increases the oxygen level.
Why is that important?
Well, the oxygen helps separate the iron and hydrogen sulfide, both of which occur naturally in the groundwater. The iron gives it that rust colour, and you can sometimes see this on fences that have been exposed to groundwater from garden bores. And hydrogen sulfide is a gas which has a really strong smell. It's a bit like rotten egg.
Oh, I've definitely smelt that coming from garden bores.
The Wanneroo groundwater treatment process uses an innovative water treatment process, MyX, after aeration. At full capacity of the plant, half of the water is treated by MyX, while the other half is treated by the standard treatment process. Chlorine is added to the water before it enters the MyX, or standard treatment processes, to help separate any iron that was not removed fully through the aeration process.
What exactly is MyX, and why don't you just stick with the standard treatment?
Well, like I said before, MyX stands for Magnetic Ion Exchange. And while the standard processes do remove some of the organic material from the water, MyX is more efficient at removing a wider range of these materials. So it means that we can consistently and more efficiently treat the water.
Once the water has been treated by MyX, it comes into these large tanks, which are called clarifiers. At the clarifiers, a chemical called alum is used to help separate the colour and turbidity particles in the water. These particles bind to alum and become heavier than the water.
We also add polyelectrolyte, which is a primary flocculant chemical, which helps the particles to separate from the clean water by allowing them to sink to the bottom of the tank.
What exactly is the difference between the MIACs and the standard treated water at this point?
Well, we need to keep the chemistry of the water right, and pH is an important part of controlling the treatment process. Now, the water that's been treated by MIACs does not need any pH adjustment. However, the water that's been treated by the standard process does, and to do that, we use lime. After clarification, the water from both the MIACs and standard treatment processes come together for filtration.
Here, the water goes through deep bed filters, which contain carbon, sand, and blue metal to remove any particles that may have carried over from the clarifiers.
The filters are regularly cleaned by backwashing, which means that the water goes in the reverse direction to push out particles in the filter. The backwash water goes back to aeration, the first step in the process, to be treated again.
And what happens to the particles that have been cleaned out of the filters?
Well, we call that sediment, and that goes to drying beds and then to landfill sites. After filtration, the water goes into the clear water tank, which is the last step before it's added to our drinking water supply. Before it goes into the tanks, however, we add fluoride and chlorine to make it suitable for drinking.
So after the water has been through the full treatment process, where does it go?
We move it to the Wanneroo Reservoir, where it then feeds into a network of pipes that supply the northern suburbs of Perth.
Throughout the process, how do you make sure the water is being treated properly?
We have checkpoints along the way that measure different aspects of water quality. This is all captured by our monitoring and control system that allows us to keep track of it. We also ensure water quality by testing all the water supply sources in Western Australia.
Thanks, Javon. Now that I've seen all the work that goes into making water ready to drink, I have a whole new perspective on the water that comes out of my tap.
Well, that's great. It really is a precious resource, and we always need to be mindful about how much we use. So thank you very much for coming.
Thank you very much for having me.
See ya.
Bye.